the early 80s, while I was making my transition from the Runaways to LITA FORD, we had photographers that were like family to us, and they grew up as along with us as we grew, the photographers grew, and you got to know them and you got to pick and choose your favorite photographers and, you know, how they worked and how they liked to work and where their studio was. And Mark Weiss was one of them. He was one of my favorite, still is one of my favorite photographers, like a brother. Now, still like a brother. He shot the very first photo session we did was me with a little hat on my hands and knees with my butt hanging out and some boots that came up just over my knees. Somebody told me sex sells, so I thought I'd give it a shot. To present day, actually, Mark still is in my life and shot my last album cover, which was Living Like a Runaway. He came up with the vision. I told him about the song. One day he just calls me and says, hey, what are you doing? And I said, oh, I'm just about ready to shoot the album cover for my new album, which is called Living Like a Runaway. And Mark goes off and starts saying, well, what if we did this? And what if we did that? I'm ripping my hair out thinking, that's perfect. Let's do it. That's perfect. So I hopped on a plane, flew to New Jersey and Red Bank, New Jersey, and we walked around the area just shooting different stuff. The day was long. We started early in the morning, and by the end of the day, the sun was just about to go down, and we looked at each other and we saw a set of railroad tracks. And I looked at Mark and Mark looked at me and we went, ooh. Railroad tracks. It's living like a runaway. You know, you can just picture yourself walking away with that little knapsack over your shoulder or a guitar, walking away down those railroad tracks. And it was perfect for the album cover. It's a billboard that said missing, the guitar propped up against the lamppost. Then the train came by and honked at us, and we had to get the hell out of there fast because the cops were coming. So we bolted into Mark's studio and turned off the lights and acted like nobody was there so the cops couldn't find us. It was awesome. I went to a party last Saturday night. I didn't get laid. I got in a fight. It ain't no big thing. Late for my job and the traffic was bad. $10 from my old man. It ain't no big thing. I went.